हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम आफ्टर द समर वेकेशंस। फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज वट एवर वी हैव डन बिफोर द समर वेकेशंस। देयर वी हैव डन सम टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव डन द सिंपलेस्ट सब्सटेंस दैट इज नोन एज एलिमेंट। नाउ दिस एलिमेंट इज मेड अप ऑफ एटम्स एंड एटम्स आर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय सिंबल। So the symbolic representation for a element is symbol. For example, if sodium, the symbol is Na. If it is carbon, the symbol is C. If it is sulfur, the symbol is S. Now all the elements have atomic masses. Why? Because they are made up of atoms. And atoms have atomic masses. Now what is atomic mass? Now this is the mass of one atom of an element, how much it is heavier than that of one atom of hydrogen. For example, if carbon's atomic mass is 12, that means carbon is 12 times heavier than that of one atom of hydrogen. Why? Because hydrogen has the simplest element with the least atomic mass, that is one atomic mass unit. If sodium is 23, then that means sodium is 23 times heavier than that of hydrogen atom. Now this atomic mass is also taken as comparison to the carbon atom. But carbon atom is already heavier than hydrogen, 12 times heavier. So what we are taking? What is atomic mass of an element? Now if it is sodium, it is 23 times heavier than that of 1/12 of carbon 12, because carbon is already 12 times heavier than hydrogen. Now these elements, when combined, they form compound. Element form compound. This compound we also called as molecule. What is a molecule? That is a combination of two or more atoms, whether they are same kind of atoms or they are different kind of atoms. Now these compounds are represented by molecular formula. So symbolic representation of compound, that is molecular formula. Now this molecular formula, for example, if it is sodium chloride, molecular formula is sodium chloride. If it is carbon dioxide, molecular formula is carbon dioxide. Ferric chloride, molecular formula is FeCl3. Now, the compounds, just like elements have atomic masses, the compounds have molecular masses. Now, what is molecular mass? So molecular mass again compared with the hydrogen atom or carbon 12. Now what is the molecular mass of a compound? This is the total mass of all the atoms present in one molecule of that compound. Now for example, if we want to count the molecular mass of carbon dioxide, now here carbon dioxide is one atom. So 1 into carbon plus 2 atoms of oxygen. Now the mass of carbon is 12 and oxygen is 16. That means 1 into 12 plus, that means 12 plus. So mass of carbon dioxide, molecular mass of carbon dioxide is 44. Same way water. So two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. You have hydrogen, one atomic mass into 16. 2 plus 16, so 18. So what is the molecular mass? You can say this is the mass of one heavier than that of atom of one atom of hydrogen or 1/12 of carbon 12. Now, one element or one compound combine, or when two compounds combine, the process is known as chemical reaction. Now, this chemical reaction is represented in this chemical equation. So, this is the symbolic representation of reaction. Now, the substances that react, they are always that are produced, they always written on right side. So, and products on right side. Now, this ways. Now, let us discuss this. So, many ways. Now, the first way, when reactant is only one, but two or three. So, for example, this is magnesium carbonate. When you heat it, decomposes into magnesium oxide and carbon dioxide. Nitrate, when you heat it, decomposes into sodium nitrite and oxygen. Calcium hydroxide, when it is heated, decomposes into calcium oxide and water. So, reactant is one. On heating, it is decomposes into two or three products. So, here all three reactions, when the products are only two. So, when zinc nitrate is heated, decomposes into two zinc oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen, three products. Copper nitrate decomposes into copper oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. We have three products here. Next type is when reactants are two and the product is only one. This is also known as decomposition reaction. This is also known as combination reaction. So in first case, ammonium chloride. Same way, when sodium oxide react with water, it produces sodium hydroxide. When sulfur dioxide react with water, it produces sulfurous acid. It gives ammonia. So, two reactants and third type of reaction, when the reactants are two and the products are also two. Such kind of reactions are double decomposition reaction or precipitate reaction. So when NaOH react with sodium hydroxide, react with hydrochloric acid, the product is sodium chloride and water. Two reactants and two products. Same way, when potassium hydroxide react with sulfuric acid, we get two product, potassium sulfate and water. Nitrate react with sodium chloride, again we have two product, sodium chloride and silver chloride and sodium nitrate. When copper sulfate react with sodium hydroxide plus we have sodium sulfate. This reaction takes place by exchanging the radicals of both the reactants. The last type is two reactants and three or more products. So the first reaction, we have zinc plus concentrated sulfuric acid. You have zinc sulfate, water and sulfur dioxide. Now remember student, it is concentrated sulfuric acid that gives three products. Whereas remember, when zinc react with H2SO4, then it gives only two product, that is zinc sulfate and hydrogen comes out. So the reaction depends on the reactants. The next is when manganese dioxide react with hydrochloric acid, we have manganese chloride, water and chlorine gas. So these are the four types of reactions, and next tomorrow we will. Thank you.